Yeah, tick season has started in the Northern Hemisphere, and letters with outdoor photos, videos, and requests to recognize arthropods on pants or on dog or on child raining down on our mail. Here is the first such letter and videos from our viewer. In this video, the arthropod is not clearly visible on the fabric of the trousers, but the next fragment clearly shows that this is really a tick. And yes, it is an exotic tick. It looks like a male castor bean tick, but I cannot identify its species for sure from this video. But it's not necessary, really. With a high probability, it belongs to the ticks that transmit dangerous infections. And maybe exactly this fellow is infected with some such disease. Maybe Lyme disease, maybe tick-borne encephalitis, pyroplasmosis, Mediterranean spotted fever, or some other nasty things. A castor bean tick can be a vector for dozens of different infections. So being able to recognize these ticks so that you can get them off yourself before they bite you is a very useful skill, especially for those people who like to spend time outdoors. And to recognize a tick, just count its legs. Ticks are members of the arachnid class, and all animals in this class, in the adult stage, have 8 legs. Neither insects nor terrestrial crustaceans have exactly that many legs. Insects have 6 legs and woodlice have 14 legs. That is, if someone with 8 legs crawls on your leg or on your pant leg, is either a tick or a spider. Either one is not good, and this 8-legged one must be thrown off as quickly as possible. Ticks in general have a fairly recognizable body shape and appearance. They have a clearly visible gnathosoma, the front part of the body with the jaws, which visibly protrudes forward. And the character of the movement of their legs is also quite recognizable. Whoever has seen several ticks will definitely recognize this creature next time. And it is easy to distinguish them from spiders. Their legs are not long, with few exceptions, and body is flat, at least until the tick has not sucked blood yet. Spiders have longer legs and are usually more bulging body. In addition, there are no parasites among spiders. They are all predators, with one and only herbivorous exception. A spider can accidentally end up on your pant leg if it fell on it from a blade of grass, but a spider will not purposefully crawl on your clothes or skin for a long time. Moreover, the spider will not stick to the skin and will not suck blood. This tick has all features: 8 short legs, flat but relatively wide body, visible mouth parts. This is a typical exotic tick. A larger tick can be confused with a Lowe's fly or cat. These flies also have a flat body and thickened legs. When the loose fly clings to the animal or human hair, it breaks off its wings and becomes even more like a tick. However, its main feature remains. Like all insects, it has 6 legs, by which it can easily be distinguished from a tick. The larvae of exotic ticks, by the way, have 6 legs. But these larvae are very small and they attack humans very rarely. Their main hosts are mouse-like rodents, so you will almost certainly not find them on your pants. But if such a larva catches on a dog, you will find it when it is sucking blood and you will not have any doubts that it is a tick. But most likely you will not find it in a dog's hair because its body length is about 1 millimeter. And with its brown color, it is almost invisible on a dog or on a cat. The question is whether to order the treatment of the courtyard from these ticks, if you have made this arthropod on your pants here. For your complete peace of mind on the garden, yeah, it is better to exterminate them. If a tick on the plot is found like this, crawling along the pant leg, it surely means that it lives in the yard and this is where it got caught on your pants. There is another good way to determine if there are ticks on the courtyard. Take a white sheet and walk around the plot on a warm sunny day, dragging the sheet behind you through the grass. If there are ticks, they will cling to the white fabric sheet and you will inspect it, see them and know that they live on the plot. If you don't catch any on the sheet and you don't encounter any on yourself, then you can rest easy. You don't have ticks in your garden. If you find a sucking tick on the dog on the plot, but the dog regularly goes outside the plot and even more runs in semi-wilderness areas, on fields, wastelands, roadsides, this situation is ambiguous. A dog can get a tick outside and bring it to your plot, and in this case it is not a fact that ticks live in the yard and you have to exterminate them. But if, for example, the dog regularly gets ticks somewhere and you don't know where exactly, but your plot borders with uncultivated area, wasteland for example, or forest or fallow field, then it is better to regularly treat garden in order to prevent ticks from migrating here. Small larvae can be brought here by the wind. Ticks of all ages can come here on wild animals, on mice for example, hedgehogs, lizards, and fall away from them in your yard. And if a fed up female ends up on the yard in this way, it will lay her eggs and larvae will hatch here. To prevent this, it is better to treat the plot with acaricides once a year, better in spring, when the soil warms up to 10 to 12 degrees Celsius, and then not remember about ticks until the end of the year. And if you do this treatment every year, ideally every spring, you will never meet these guys near your house at all. And if you found something similar on yourself, but nevertheless, either you could not count its legs or still doubt the identification, then be like the author of this video. Take a picture of this unknown creature closer and clearer and send these videos and photos to my mail. I will try to figure out what you have captured.